Nick DeShawn here for the Grambling State broadcast. I'm here with my boy Dame. We're getting ready for game three of this doubleheader. Last game, the GSU Fighting Tigers did fell short 13-0. The Lady Tigers of Texas Southern finished with 13 runs on 16 hits, committing no errors. While the Lady Tigers only finished with one hit and two errors. Dame, what do you expect coming into this game? Just say, looking at the first game, it's been an upset week this week. I mean, from high school to SWAC, first game, we actually won 2-0 with Texas Southern out hitting us by 6-4 while no errors. Tamaya Johnson and Kaylin Wall finished with two runs in that. But Jada Williams with the big dominant game in the first game with six outs.
As long as most of you are dominant, they'll be fine. Everybody will be well.
I think our fielding is doing great. Last game probably was just a lot of mental rolls. But this game, I think we're going to have a lot of adjustments, play right, play ground ball, and we'll get straight.
Yeah, exactly.
She will be out. GSU with their first out of the game. Right, you got to credit that to Jada Williams. I mean, she's a very – like a ball hog when it comes to putting things out.
He's swarming.
With a hit, and that will be called. GSU with their second out of the game. But Texas Southern will get their first point of the game with the sacrifice fly. Two outs. I think we're comfortable in this. Strike. Dame, next week, ranked football, man. You excited or what?
Oh,
I'm excited. One ball, two outs. Just one more. Right, and today we got our final game with the baseball team. That was a battle yesterday. I think they're going to get it together and get this win. Right now, we're sitting third in the SWAC for baseball. Yesterday, I seen the freshman sensation. I forgot his name, excuse me, on that, but he had a big-time triple.
Oh, yeah, I said that too.
Yeah, it can.
Points approved.
Right. And she will be out. Heading to the bottom of the first. Your GSU Tigers are down by one. Coming up for Lincoln Parish area, so some softball. The Lady Krugers of Cedar Creek dominated yesterday in New Orleans, beating Lewis McGee 23-0. Now they will head to Opelousas next week to face the number one team in their in that conference, Opelousas Catholic. Now with that team, Anna Fitzgerald, that's the name you're gonna hear. I think she's an eighth grader or a freshman. Four runs, a one big in the house home run. But their pitching staff is a dominant team as well. I seen them play against Manny 2 weeks back. I mean, they can make them big pitching plays. But a team that we've been rooting for, the Lady Tigers of Simsboro, they came up big Friday against Evans. Matter of fact, one of our staff workers at Tiger Huddle, Tamaya Johnson, she's coming up at bat. She came and saw the game too as well. So a lot of big energy coming in this weekend for the Diamond. Now coming up at the bat, what do you expect for Tamaya coming into this first pitch?
It's my call, so.
Hey, it's all love.
So with Tamaya, everything she does is confident, man. With her, it's just stay confident.
Like you said, man, she's been at bat 100 times with 16 runs, 23 hits, 5 doubles, 0 triples, but she do have 11 RBIs. So let's see what she do right now.
And she has really good IQ.
Right.
Really good IQ.
So she will get the ball for the first pitch of this inning. Two oh count right now. Exactly. But see, with her veteran skills, she know how to play the ball right. So it's just the beginning of the game. She knows how to articulate this when it comes to the mental aspect of this game. She will take the walk as I expected. Like the game plan. Like the game plan. Caitlin Walls on the bat. Another one. She batting average of 228 with 92 times being at bat, 16 runs, 21 hits, and 2 doubles. Ooh, what a foul ball.
Ready to.
Exactly. But like I mentioned yesterday, I mean, looking at the stats statistically, yeah, they're at low, you know, in the low rankings, but that's based off me personally, I say the computer algorithm of with the losses. That will be, she will be out, but she will get be saved.
Great teamwork.
So she will take the sacrifice fly. Right now, your GSU Lady Tigers are ranked second to last in the standings behind a hopeless Alcorn State. So today, they got to get a win because Alcorn, they actually came up top yesterday and beat Southern, if I'm not mistaken. Looking at the batting, bro, we're second to last behind Mississippi Valley right now with a team average of 219 at the moment. So this is not our strong department, like mentioned. But I mean, here's the bright side, though. Team is young. Team is young. I would say our most, you know, key players are 2 freshmen. You know? So I mean, we're getting a development. Right. Oh, what a nice hit! And she will be out. Right. Tavius, the freshman, and she's come from a school with a resume of softball. Calvary Baptist, I got to see them play beginning of the season against Ruston. Them girls, they put up 18 runs on the Bearcats, man. So that 3A team out of the Shreveport area, man, I think, matter of fact, looking at the bracket, we have it pulled up. Let me just see where they at right now. Right. Calvary Baptist actually had a bye week this week, and they will be playing number 17 Beekman Charter in your Division III Select playoffs. So looking at their schedule, I mean, overall, I mean, I see a lot of W's. They only have 1 loss against a St. Thomas More coming out of the Lafayette area. But that loss wasn't even a loss. I mean, you lose 3-5 to a good, 4A team of St. Thomas More and have a lot of these wins. I mean, I don't know what they do over there, man. And she will be out. Now heading to the top of the second. Your GSU Tigers are still down by one.
Yes, sir. Oh, okay, I got you. Okay, I got you. I got you.
Coming up at bat for your Texas Southern Tigers, number 35. Sanaya Henderson at bat. One ball, zero strikes right now at this moment. Damn, like we were talking about earlier, I mean, Lady Tigers are fifth in pitching right now with a strikeout of 101 strike. Ooh! At bat, number 16. Madison Giggs. Right. Okay, come on, we gotta make some miscommunications. We gotta get it, bro. We gotta play her down right now. Lack of communication. Nobody called the ball, no ball, none of that. Right. strike. Nice pitch. Nice pitch. Well, perfect. I just been covering softball all this month, and it's one thing about them strikes. I just don't know what it is. Right. She will take the ball, and she will be out. Jada Williams with the caught stolen, man. What I told you, man. Jada is a ball hawk. A ball hawk. One out, one ball, one strike. Let's get another out. Foul ball. Two balls, two strikes. We got a 2-2 count going on right now. I think she's going to make it a 3-2 count, but I'm more of a 2-3 count type of guy. Oh, okay, a 3-2 count. She will be out. But the Lady Tigers do get a sacrifice fly, making the score 2-0. Number 8, Marissa Martinez. We got ourselves a left-hander.
Sometimes the most dangerous one.
Right.
Speaking from a left-hander.
One ball. Foul ball. 1-1 count. It up. The Lady Tigers will take a big time triple. Man, and but besides home runs, a triple to me is like one of the, you know, effort plays from baseball to softball. I like watching. I watched Rustin High versus Les Monroe and Jackson Lee. He made a big time triple to get the game winning win for the Bearcats that Friday, if I'm not mistaken. But speaking of the Bearcats, man, they took a hard loss yesterday, finishing that final district series against West Monroe. But it's still great to see the Bearcats pull off a win against the number one team in the division of 5A. So much love to Coach Willis over there. We will be there Monday against their final game against Franklin Parish. But as of now, we have ourselves a 1-2 count. Right. It's a mental game at this moment right now. I think she's going to shake it off.
That's it. She's got to shake it off.
Ourselves a 2-2 count. Now, dang, this is a 2-2 count that's different. You got two balls, two strikes, and two outs. The decision like this, do you take the swing or do you take that ball?
I
Lady Tigers of Texas Southern will get that big time double. Fielding, we gotta get it together right now, man. We're not looking too keen at this moment. We're gonna get it together. It's only the second inning. We're gonna get it together.
Let's regroup.
Okay, so what I'm gonna show you is these are like sunglasses for the camera when it's really bright. So you leave that on automatic.
And that will conclude that inning. Heading to the bottom of the second. Your GSU Tigers are down by three. While we transition to the bottom of the second, we got ourselves a quick score update powered by KGRM. Your Cedar Creek Krugers dominated Evangeline Christian 14-3 yesterday. In a commanding display of skills and determination, your Cedar Creek Krugers asserted their dominance over the Eagles of Evangeline Christian. Ladd Thomas with a stellar performance at bat. We saw him collect three hits at five at bat, including a crucial single in the first, fourth, and seventh inning. His consistency set the tone for the offense for the Krugers. But the Krugers did not waste no time asserting their dominance, with Chad Yates igniting a scoring in the first inning with a double, followed by Max Brichter with a two-run single. Now at bat, Nia Jones. Jones at bat. Dame, I don't know if you've seen it, but last week she made that big time walk off hit against Perryview. Right. The Lafayette native will get one ball with zero strikes at the moment. Let's see what the game plan for her is. Right now, another ball, 2-0 count. Right now, Nia Jones has a batting average of 167, being at bat 55 times with one run, nine hits, one double, and seven RBIs. She will get the strike, a 2-1 strike right there. She'll take the hit, and she will be out. Right. Peyton Crenshaw at the bat right now with a batting average of 265, being at bat 34 times with one run, nine hits, two doubles, five RBIs, and 11 total bases. With her, she's a powerful hitter. Let's see what the game plan is. I think she's going to send a missile. Strike. 0-1 count right now for you, Lady Tigers. Strike. 0-2 count right now for you, Lady Tigers. Foul ball. Take one ball. One ball, two count. Thank you. Not a substitute too? Count.
Like it's coming.
You feel like it's coming, Dave? Let's see. Let's see. Let's see what the decision is going to be. Strike. Right now, at bat number 13, freshman Lexi Hope. Most definitely.
Silent, but she definitely can hit.
Wait. So we got ourselves a quick little sports adjustment update for your Grambling State Lady softball teams. This Wednesday, your Lady Tigers will be in Ouachita Parish taking on the Warhawks of University of Louisiana. And then we're back at action 6 o'clock April 23rd at the Russell Sports Complex to take on the Arlington Baptist. Oh, they don't know. They don't have a logo on here, but they're playing Arlington Baptist. Ooh. 2-2 count. Damn, like I said, we're at a 2-2-2 count right now.
Right back at it.
It's like one of those, you make the free throw, you point 5 seconds. You make the shot, you win type of ordeal. So what's the game plan? Oh, it's one ball, two strikes. And nice little hit, but she will be out. Now heading to the top of your third. Your Grambling State Lady Tigers are down by 3. As we transition to the third inning, here's a quick score update for your Lincoln Parish area teams. The Aggies of Soudre dominated the Bulldogs of Forest High in this weekend's doubleheader for the district matchup. In a commanding display of skills and determination, the Aggies of Soudre outscored the Bulldogs in 2 games of a score of 36 points to 1 run in the weekend district doubleheader. Which means after Monday, when the Louisiana Athletic Association's make the playoff bracket, they will actually win District 2B. Congrats to the Aggies of Soudre for that accomplishment. I mean,
right. These
guys been dominating. The softball team got a bye week last week for softball, and they will be playing Fairway this Wednesday. They have a bye week as well. They were ranked 3. So with this win right here, your Aggies of Soudre will be ranked in the 14th spot in Division 5 non-select. We will put them in a position to be. The goal is to get a top 15 spot in that playoff bracket to get a home game. But if playoffs was happening today, they'll have a home game versus the Zowie Hawks, 19 ranked.
So with all these softball and baseball games here in high school, I mean, you got more experience than I do, Nick. So how do you feel about all that? You know, how exciting it is, all of that.
I love it. I love it. I love it. I love the energy. I love the kids. I love the coaches, the parents. Because one thing about Lincoln Parish is the parents let the kids play. The umpire let the kids play. It's a great environment. Everybody is on the line. Everybody's using the same statistical app. So it's easy on my end to report everything.
Right.
So it's just a great experience. And I'm excited for spring football and summer volleyball.
Okay.
Got ourselves a 1-0 count right now for your Lady Tigers of Texas Southern. Oh, 2-0 count right now for your Lady Tigers. What a hit. Let's see if she will get it out. And that will be their first out.
That's communication. That's all you need.
Ball.
see.
Ooh, we'll get this. Let's see. Oh, we got ourselves an error. Lady Tigers will get a big-time double. This has to be their third or fourth double in this game today.
And Nick, I'm going to tell you something that my coach used to tell me in high school when I was playing football. Even though I wasn't, you know, a guy that could catch up on defense.
Right.
You got to look the ball in all the way. All the way. That's how you're able to catch it a lot better. Look it in.
Straight. Got ourselves an 0-1 count right now with one out. Nice hit, but she will.
Yeah, Maya.
Was that out? Was that out?
Yes.
Amazing catch.
Did they count it?
See you, Uno.
They should.
No, they didn't count it. So we got two at base. Yep. Right. Ooh, and she will be out. Quick work. But just looking at your Lady Tigers of Texas Southern, there is second ranked in the SWAC West. 6-6 as conference record, 12 wins with 14 losses. I give it to them. But let's look at the statistical side of your Lady Tigers. In the batting department, they are ranked fifth with a batting average of 270. Number six, Madison Giggs will get striked. Ball. 1-1 count right now for your Lady Tigers. Strike! 1-2 count for your Lady Tigers.
She is on a roll.
I think she could just strike. This would be a game changer right here. Foul ball. Another foul ball. So she's battling with this one. This is a great, this is, right. I mean, you got two at base, so the game plan is if you can hit it to the right field and get that RBI for 23, but looking at it, I mean, I think we're going to be here all day. Another foul ball.
He's not trying to drown in that water, man.
Let's see. She will be out. Now heading to your bottom third. Your GSU Tigers are still down by three.
All they got to do is take their time.
Take their time, man. Look, we're not in a hurry. We got, you know.
Not rushing. Please. Get back in this game.
Thank you. As we transition to the bottom third, Dame, I want to pick your brain right quick. Swag baseball this week. LSU, they fall short to the Jaguars. And then last 2 days ago, if I'm not mistaken, the Hornets, Alabama State, they took the War Eagles down 3-2, man. What's your thoughts on the Swag dominating them against the SEC?
I love it. I still got a bad taste in my mouth when we went to LSU and we lost to the Tigers at they field.
So right.
As many times as we can't keep moving these guys wrong, and we can't compete.
I mean, I think, you know, we got a date coming up with the Tigers at the end of this month. So, I think if we get it together and expose them, I mean, we're going to put Swag on the map.
Yeah. That's all it's about. We can't compete. Obviously, we're moving wrong.
Exactly. Right now at bat, Deidre Russell. Being at bat 72 times with 10 runs with 12 hits, 2 doubles, 5 RBIs, and 14 total bases. And Ms. Russell will be striked.
One thing I know about Deja Russell is that since I've been watching her since sophomore, she is a wild card.
Right. A Swiss Army knife.
Yeah, so she can do it all.
Oh. You got one ball, one strike. Houston native will get another ball, 2 balls, 1 strike. Ooh. Almost, 5 ball. I like the effort. Damn, if you was Coach Hall right now, what are you telling your girls coming into this inning?
Stay poised, stay calm. You know, take your time. Read the ball. Literally. You know what I mean?
Out.
That's what it's really all about. You got to stay poised. Down 3-0, you know, you can't rush it because you're going over other things. You're going to make more mistakes.
Right. Coming up at bat, another Houston native, Jada Williams. Like we talked about earlier, Jada is a ball hawk. Like a ball hawk when it comes to catching. But batting, every year I've seen her throughout these last 3 years, it's been an improvement. This year she's getting hits, she's getting runs, she's strategizing. Last season, she was just excited to get at bat. Now we're starting to see a mental shift where she's fundamentally getting her sound right.
Getting more involved with everything.
Exactly. Right. 1 ball, 1 strike for the Houston native. Since we're talking about Jada Williams, she leads the SWAC and caught stealing by with 13. And she's in the lower ranking of pass balls with only 5. So, bless you. I've seen an improvement with her. Foul ball. Right, and she will be out. Samaya Johnson back at bat. Strike. Tennessee native will get the strike for this inning. Ball, we got ourselves a 1-1 count. Oh, we got ourselves a 2-1 count. Oh, we got ourselves a 3-1 count. Like we said with Tamaya, I mean, she's a veteran. She's know how to manipulate the game mentally when it comes to certain situations. I think she's going to take this walk, try to get one more pitch in, and she will be out. Great effort with her, man.
Right now, the Tigers are trying to find a rhythm.
Right.
Trying to find an opening so they can, you know, dominate or, you know, shift the energy.
Right.
It's being a little difficult right now.
Heading into the top of the fourth, your GSU Lady Tigers are still down by 3. We're not seeing any, you know, mental woes before in this game. They're just getting things together. Let's dominate. Let's get this change. Everything is going to happen, and we're holding them accountable. Dame, now heading into the top four, man. If you was playing, what's the game plan? What you think needs to be the swift if you was a player for the Lady Tigers?
Man, I think one of it is crouching down, you know, clamming down. Because with Texas Southern right now, they're hitting everything dead center or dead left, you know what I mean?
Right.
And, you know, choose the side, you know, because at this point, right now.
She will get the out. Tamaya Johnson with the put out.
It's beautiful. So exactly that. You have to do every single time.
Got
to
make them plays.
Yeah.
Have to make them plays. Big plays.
Crowding. That was just beautiful. A beautiful play from Tamaya because, you know, she's showing pure athleticism.
Pure athleticism. Much love. A mass comm major. Shouts out to her. You go, girl.
Shout out to the lady kickback, you know.
We got ourselves a 1-0 count right now, heading to the top of the fourth, a one out. At bat number 8, Marissa Martinez. Right! Got ourselves a 1-1 count right now. Oh, that will be out by the freshman Cameron Broussard, another player on this Grambling State team that's been dominating this season. 2 weeks ago, I gave her a KGRM, Knicks Pick Big Dog List Player of the Week, and she is showing an example why she deserves to be a Player of the Week.
That's what I'm talking about, man. Sometimes those team player roles last, you know what I mean? You need some more team players.
Exactly. And she's playing her role well. Got ourselves a foul ball. Hit it, Jada. Almost hit the ump. Ump ain't even paying attention. Got ourselves a 1-1 count. Dan, let me pick your brain right quick. What's your thoughts on Tiger Woods making a comeback? Well, speaking of the Masters, we got ourselves a Lincoln Parish native, Sam Burns. He's getting ready for the Masters as well. It's been a long week for him, but he's getting it together. Lady Tigers missed the catch. They will get the single. Because, man, we can't afford having a ball in that parking lot and hitting our cars. Right. Ooh, they missed it. They would advance. So we got two at base right now at the moment. Exactly, man. Exactly. Strike. Pam Richardson at bat for the Lady Tigers of Texas Southern. Oh, we got a 1-1 count. Oh, we almost had it. Now the bases will be loaded. No. She was safe. So the Lady Tigers will get another point. It's 4-4 right now. Right now, if you're the Lady Tigers, what's going on, Dame? What's going through your head?
They're just overthinking it, man. Just too many, too many rushes. It's like trying to get to the ball and not really focusing on getting the ball.
Right. We got ourselves a ball. 1-0 count right now for the Lady Tigers. We got ourselves a hit, and that will be gone. Lady Tigers will get an RBI single. And she will be saved at the second base. 6-0 for the Texas Southern Lady Tigers. Yep, it's a regroup right now. I think Coach Hall is trying to get these girls to understand that, hey, it's one inning at a time. We got to work on this before we get to the next thing.
Exactly.
Yeah, I got you. At bat, number 37, Angel Morales. So, Dame, are you attending the baseball game for later today?
It depends, man.
It's a beautiful Sunday. I mean, it's sunny. Yeah. Man, I'm trying to go get me a fish pole and go get some bass right now, man.
Right. That's what I like, man. Countryside.
Yeah.
We far on the West Coast, though.
That's right. We got ourselves a 2-1 count right now for the Lady Tigers. And she will be out.
Beautiful catch.
What a play by Nia Jones. Now heading to the bottom of the fourth. Your Grambling State Lady Tigers are down by 6.
Now these Lady Tigers got to regroup now, you know. Figure out what their game plan is.
At bat, Caitlin Walls. Now she's one of those Swiss Army knives for this Lady Tiger team with a batting average of .223, being at bat 92 times with 16 runs with 21 hits. I mean, 4 RBIs with 25 total bases? I mean, you can't ask for nothing more, man. We got ourselves an 0-1 count here. Okay, we'll take it. We got ourselves an 0-2 count right now. Foul ball. Strike. Oh, wait. Let's go on. It's one ball, two. Ump just was ready to just say out, to be honest with you. And I love it. I mean, them umps, man, you got to love the umps, man. When they in tune with the game and let the girls play. We got ourselves a 2-2 count. Okay, and it's in, and she will be out. Now at bat, the freshman, Cam Brewster. Cam Brewster leads the team in a batting average of .319, being at bat 91 times with 20 runs, 29 hits, 7 doubles, 3 big-time triples, and 10 RBIs. What more can you ask from a freshman? The Lake Charles native. with the 1-0 with the 0-1 count. 1-1 count right now for the Lady Tigers. Like mentioned before, I named her my first player of the week for our KGRM Knicks Pick Big Dog list. With a strike right now, just showing how these freshmen in the Lincoln Parish area are dominating. I named her, and then I named Cedar Creek pitcher Cade Luker. He's a left-hand pitcher, and Nate and Dame, you got to see this guy. He's, man, he pitched like he's a senior. Right. Right. Now heading into the bat, number 15, Tavia. So we got back-to-back freshmen at base. I don't stress about these two because I know the next 3 to 4 years is going to be something magical. Right now we got ourselves a 1-0 count with two outs right now heading to the bottom of the fourth. My leg. My leg. What a hit. She will. Let's see. And she was out. Out. Now heading to the top of the third. Your Grambling State Lady Tigers are down. Oh, top of the fifth. Your Grambling State Lady Tigers are down by six. Put the bat to ball. That's all. We got to play physical. We're not playing physical. The girls got to get here and be aggressive. Now is not the time to be pretty, girls. Now is not time to be pretty right now. Now is time to get ugly and get aggressive. We're at the top field. You know, it's two more innings. Let's get this game rolling.
I also think that we need to let the bat go.
Right.
So we can just let the bat go, man. Give it what we got. We can get somewhere.
Exactly. As we transition to the top of the fifth, we got ourselves a sports update. We got ourselves a sports update. So for the second round for the Lady Tigers of Simsboro, they will travel to Zowie Monday, 5 o'clock. Admissions will be $8. We encourage everybody in the Lincoln Parish area to show up and support your Lady Tigers of Simsboro. Now at bat, number 15, Madison Martinez with the out. Now at bat, number 16, Madison Griggs. She will be. Oh. We got two out, back to back. Dang, what's the game plan? You think they're listening to us?
Yeah.
Now at bat, number 7, Marissa Perella. All right, we got ourselves a 1-0 count. We got ourselves a 2-0 count. Let's see. Let's do. And she will be out. Now heading to the bottom of the fifth. Your Grambling State Lady Tigers are standing on business. Man, now Dane, what you think the batting staff got to do?
Batting staff, got to let the bat go. Simple. Let the bat go.
Yeah, don't. Right.
And just let it go. Just like you said earlier. Gotta put the bat to the softball, man.
Right, yeah. Just like this song. Everybody gotta play their part. Let's move your feet. At bat coming up, number three, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, number three, Nia Jones. To the bottom field. Gotta play their part. Let's go, Grambling Lady Tigers. That's an 0-1 count right now for the Lady Tigers. Nia Jones. The Red Shirt Junior from Cameron Crowe, Louisiana, at bat. Last week was her birthday, and I guess she's standing on business with a birthday gift with that walk-off run against Prairie View. So let's see what the native of Louis Lafayette can do. Ooh, but that will be foul. Let's go, Lady Tigers. We're at the bottom of the fifth of the Tiger Bowl. Let's, with this win, teams will get bragging rights on who get to be the Tiger of the Swag. Besides Jackson State. Man, I didn't notice. We got like three Tigers in the Swag. Jaguars, Tigers, Lions. Ooh. Since you're talking about that, do you think the SWAC is going to have a conference realignment? Like teams like Tennessee State, Arkansas, at Atlanta Clark, do you think them schools would try to transition to the SWAC?
Well, that is a good question. Let it take a while because, you know, Grambling would be
fun. Right.
Schools like that would be too, you know, a lot of schools, you know,
right.
You have to make a big splash, you know, to merge. But I can see that too.
Right.
Now Florida travel to Atlanta. Anywhere else.
Exactly. I mean, I'm looking at these schools, man. You know, there's a bunch of schools coming from that Conference USA transitioning to the American Conference, as schools in the American Conference are transitioning to the Big 12. Like we've seen, I want to say earlier this semester, you know, the Conference USA giving Louisiana Tech that $100,000 grant for them just staying in the conference as there being a realignment for the schools. Anaya Lee at bat. Right, we got ourselves a 1-1 count for the Lady Tigers with one at base. ourselves a 1-2 count. Anaya Lee, been at bat 34 times with two runs, seven hits, three doubles, and five RBIs. We got ourselves a foul ball. Okay, with the hit. Ooh. She made it on base, but Nia Jones will be out. They was fast enough, we would almost saw us a swag double play.
Right.
And I've seen a couple double plays before, man, from the Ruston High, West Ouachita game, to the Cedar Creek and Manny game. Them double plays, man, change, game changer, that energy changer.
Those matter the most.
Right. And that just goes to show you that your defense, man, is really dominant. So we got the freshman, Lexi Hope, at bat with a 0-1 count right now for the Lady Tigers. Got ourselves an 0-2 count. Lexi Hope right now. Oh. Foul ball. We got ourselves
one, two, three,
a dead
four.
Ball. And she will take the wall. But Lexi Hope, I mean, looking at her at the bat, she has a batting average of 118 with an OPS of 404 with four runs, four hits, and only three RBIs. But she's more dominant at the fielding position.
Yeah. I mean, she has a real good history at that position. So,
right.
You know, if anybody can do it, it's going to be her.
Like we said, another freshman, some post-hall recruiting class is really dominant. I just think, you know, the game plan is, you know, us being in the sports department covering everything, the game plan is they heard to get some of these girls out of the Lincoln Parish area.
Yeah.
That would be great.
You know, preparing for your star guys to get out of here, you know, you got to prepare for that, you know.
Mic check, 1-2.
Okay,
that was a nice hit.
And that will be Kaleo Malone with the home run. Game changer, ladies and gentlemen. We got ourselves a game changer. What a play. What a play.
Now, that's how you step up.
That's how you dominate.
That's how you step
that's
up.
That's how you dominate. Let's go. Let's go. Home run. That's how you change the game.
You done got yourself back in the game. That's how you dominate. It only takes one.
It only takes one play, like we talked about. One play,
one player, everything. Now you got to capitalize off that.
That will be her second
No, that will be her first home run of the season. Now at bat, Jada Williams, the Houston, Texas native. She got to make a change right now.
She hit that ball with conviction.
Wait, it was a two-run? All right, home run? Did not know that. I didn't know we had two at base.
Yeah, actually we did.
That's a play of the day right there, ladies and gentlemen. Highlight of the game. Big game changer. Now they're only down by three. I thought it was 6-1. Got ourselves a 1-0 count right now for the Lady Tigers. I mean, dang, we talked about this throughout the whole game.
Right.
One play, and that's just the play that happened.
Yeah, now the momentum, now the team is alive. So
right.
Got to keep it going.
Exactly. We got ourselves a 1-1 count with Jada Williams at bat. That was a 2-1 count.
There it
okay,
is.
Okay, with the hit.
Is another one?
Okay. Ooh. It doesn't matter. That is a great hit for Jada Williams coming out for this season. I mean, we still got the momentum. We got two outs. But, I mean, I think this inning is a game changer. So,
I mean, it really is. You got one of your star players in Tamaya coming back into bat. And depending on what she does, might get to capitalize off this even more.
Right. So we got ourselves an 0-1 count right now for the Lady Tigers. Year or two at the JUCO, and she will be out. Now heading to the top six, your Grambling State Lady Tigers. Now scored, being down by three. Your score is Texas Southern 6, Grambling State 3. Damn, if you're Coach Hall right now, what you telling your girls right now?
We're back in this game. All you got to do is, literally, key word that I've been saying all day, I'm going to continue to say, stay calm.
Stay calm. One inning at a time.
Yes.
At this point right now, it's one pitch at a time right now.
That's the key.
Bad Marissa Martinez. Left hand. pitch and the left hand bat.
Right.
Perfect. We got ourselves the ball. 1-1 count right now for the Lake Tigers. Sets a ball. 2-1 count right now for the Lady Tigers.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Got ourselves a 3-1 count. Two count right now for the Lady Tigers.
Nerve-wracking.
Right. So, looking at Texas Southern roster and everything, I mean, you played 27 games compared to Grambling State 36 games.
Yep.
So, you're looking at it, you're more well-rested. So, I mean, they have the upper hand in that situation. But with us, I mean, we have more experience right now playing 36 games in total. But we should be well rested since, you know, that Thursday game with Arlington Baptist was canceled due to bad weather in the Arlington area.
Yeah. So it gave him a little bit more more time.
Right. But looking at the Texas Southern, you know, record, I mean, they're 2-11 away. So you got the advantage right now. Strike.
Yeah.
Right now, man. Come on, Lady Tigers. They will get the single.
And that's just the thing with Texas Southern right now. They're making powerful hits.
Right.
You know what I mean?
So coming up at bat, number 13, Paris Johnson. But looking at Texas Southern batting average, I mean, you got Angel Morrell taking the lead with a batting average of .324, being at bat 34 times, 3 runs, 11 hits, 2 doubles, 1 triple.
Right.
I mean, I'll take it. But looking at where the SWAC overall standings, hold on, I don't have it. Strike. Got ourselves an 0-2 count right now, Dame. You're Grambling. What you're doing right now?
If I'm Grambling right now, the name of the game is right now. You want to make a tight space because they're hitting everything wide. You know what I mean?
Strike! She will be out.
You want to make a very, very tight space because the last three hits have went far left.
Right.
You know what I mean? A few of them went, you know, dead center.
Coming up at bat, number 6, Pam Richardson. Right now, I mean.
So just tighten up.
Tighten up. I mean, they're getting their adjustments. Oh, that's going to be out. Oh, we got ourselves an error. Lady Tigers got 2 on base right now. That should have been out right there. We got to fix on the mental rules right there.
Yeah.
Like you hear them, play together, we're good.
Yeah, it's a lot of mental head spaces right now that are just you know, got to just shake back. That's it. That's all.
Got ourselves some strike. And that will be out. Great defense for the Lady Tigers. I mean, you had a one mental wall right there and you shook it back. I mean, then what more can you ask for these Lady Tigers?
Not anything. I mean, they're doing what they're supposed to be doing right now. You know, they got, like I said, they got back in the game, and all they got to do now is get back in the game. So,
right. You
know, stay poised.
And as we're transitioning to the bottom six, we do have a score update for your Lincoln Parish High School sports. The Tigers of Sandsboro are up by 4 against the Demons of Downville High, top of the second. With Chris Harrell having 1 run, Mark Holloway with 1 run, and 2 RBIs for Noah Thomas. Coming up at bat number 2, Kaylin Walls. Oh, with the bunt. And she will be safe. What a play for the Lady Tigers.
Great speed. That was
coming
great
up
speed.
Next is the freshman, Cameron Brusor. They're getting it together, Dame, man. You love to see it.
Yeah. The momentum is on their hands now, so capitalize.
Ooh, we got ourselves a ball. 1-0 count for the Lady Tigers.
There it is.
Uh-oh, and she will be out. Coming up at bat number 15, Tavia. We got ourselves a score update for the Lincoln Parish area. The Bulldogs, the Diamond Dogs that they would say, lost to the Wildcats of Arizona 5-2. Your Bulldogs entered 2 runs on 5 hits and 1 error.
That was a good play.
So it's a 2-0 count for the Lady Tigers. Last play, Kalen Wall with an amazing stolen base. You got a lot of stolen bases. It just shows me that your team is ready to make a gamble.
Yeah.
And I think this team is really athletic enough to make stolen bases. Because comparing watching a team like Ruston High, they're a team that prides themselves on stolen bases. And when you not really that strong at the bat, I think it's more beneficial when it comes to stolen bases.
You just got some, some teams are just willing to make that sacrifice.
We got ourselves a 3-1 count for the Lady Tigers. She's getting there. I love the fight. Okay, keep the battle. I like the battle. Keep the battle.
She fighting. Like I say, she don't want to drown.
Right. We got ourselves a 1-1 count for the Lady Tigers. To the top of the seventh, it's Lady Tigers, Texas Southern 6, your Grambling State Tigers 3. Last inning, we 6 innings ago, we didn't, you know what I'm saying?
No, yeah, 6 innings ago, it was bad.
Right.
So now, it's crunch time. That's the best way I can say it.
Now heading to the bat, Angel Morales. Mindset coming into this 7th inning. What you panicking? You nervous? What you doing if you're athlete?
as a former athlete, yes, I am nervous. So, but at the same time, I know how to keep my composure.
Right, it's all about keeping your composure. At the end of the day, we're Division I athletes commentating this game. So, I mean, you just got to play it cool. Like Coach Laura Lawson said in Duke University, you got to handle the hard harder.
Yeah. As long as they know that and as long as they're staying calm, you know, it'll be okay.
We got ourselves a substitution. Kaliana Cash will be coming in for your Lady Tigers. Another player who's been showing out. I mean, she's been getting a little repetition in when it comes to designated runners. She's also a MassCom major, too, so shout out to her.
Shout out.
And she's an all-SWAC, all-academic player as well. So it's more than just playing the game when it comes to her.
Oh, yeah.
Got ourselves a 1-0 count. We got ourselves a 1-2 count for the Lady Tigers. Tigers get their first out of the inning. Got two more left. I think they're keeping their composure.
See if they can get it.
I know they're going to get it. Right. We just need two more. Two more. They say two in a row, two in a row. Head ball, foul. Got ourselves an 0-2 count, Dame.
Yeah, man. They find the rhythm, like I said
they're
earlier.
They find the rhythm. It's always, with Grambling Softball, it's always that fifth, fourth inning where they kind of get their identity and try to get it together. Now we're seeing it. They're in a position where they got to dominate right now. And right! She's out. Skedaddle. One more. Now coming up at bat, number 16, Madison Griggs. All right, we got ourselves a 1-0 count right now for the Lady Tigers. This commentating been very easy to know that the two teams are the same Tigers, so yeah. I'm not stressing over nothing right now.
At all.
We got ourselves a 2-0 count right now for the Lady Tigers of Texas Southern.
Especially when all the HBCUs are named after cats, you know?
Right. A 2-1 count for Texas Southern. Okay. Call it. She will be out. This so far has been their best inning this inning. You know, they really getting it together. Now we're at the bottom seven. Game time, crunch time. A lot of pressure going on.
Lots. Because this is a game that Grambling needs to win.
A big win, most definitely. Just like the music, Grambling, you got to get it back in blood right now.
Exactly. But you have to get it.
Get it back.
Coming up at bat number 16, Anaya Lee.
Congratulations, sir. She just crossed Delta yesterday. So.
Okay.
So shout out to the Reds, man. Shout out to the Reds. That's who I'm with, Nick. I don't know about you.
Yeah. I love me a little bit of purple and gold. I love them dogs, man.
Yeah.
We got ourselves a 1-0 count for the Lady Tigers. Been a lot of activities this weekend for Grambling State, man.
Oh, yeah, a lot of probates. A lot of probates,
a lot of Spring Fest coming up.
Spring Fest is starting tomorrow.
Oh, it is. We got ourselves a 1-0 count. But speaking of Spring Fest, do you know who's performing?
We got Skilla Baby and a Bounce Artist.
A Bounce Artist?
Yeah.
Okay, Grambling.
Oh, Super Bad.
Super Bad.
Yeah.
With a nice hit center field, she will get the single. Let's go.
See?
I thought she left Coach Larry hanging right there.
Nah.
He was waiting for a long minute, too. Much love to him. Shouts out to Coach Larry.
Yeah.
Up next at bat, number 13, Lexi. Oh. We got ourselves an 0-1 count for the Lady Tigers. Ooh, we got ourselves a 1-1 count for the Lady Tigers. One at base, zero outs. Playing it smooth, playing it calm.
Name it again.
So if I'm Grambling, I think this would be the game plan. Get as many batters advancing to walk and then get your big hitter guy to get a big hit center field so you get the one.
Oh, that is a smart decision. Smart game plan, Nick. Because it worked the last time.
Right. We got a 2-2 count right now. Ooh. I think the game plan right here is she's going to take a walk right now. I wouldn't advise taking a swing right now, but let's see. Okay, we got ourselves a 3-2 count. Three in a row. Be smart with it, Lexi. Be smart.
Ooh,
out. Okay, we got Malone back coming from a big two-run homer. What's the game plan for her?
Do it again.
Let's see what she can do. All right, we got ourselves a ball. Sir Jr. from Opelousas, Louisiana, with a 2-0 count. We got ourselves a time right now. So it's a 2-1 count. Dang. What's the game plan? Calm coaching? What? You biting your nails?
A little bit. A little bit. It's crunch time.
Ooh. I think she's trying to chase another homer.
Yeah.
Let's play smart. Let's play focused. We're bottom seven. It's 2-2 right now. We're one out. We can't avoid any liability type.
Oh, yeah. And I can't blame her.
She will be out. Coming up at bat for your Lady Tigers, this Houston Texan native, Jado Williams. Okay, we got the Drake and the Yeet plan. Dang, get your thoughts on Drake taking over the world right now.
Hey, man, until Kendrick respond, you know, he got it for right now, you know? So, that's all I got
to
say.
Did you get a chance to hear the leak diss?
Oh, no, yeah, it was cool. Well, it was good. I ain't going to hold you.
Okay, okay.
I'm not biased.
I ain't going to front. I like the diss, but Rosé, my boy Rick Ross. Okay,
he came out left field with that one.
Stolen base. My boy Rosé, man, he came out the woodworks. Yeah. And he's busy with them lemon pepper wings, but he had to get in the studio to address
right.
Drake.
That was nasty work yesterday.
Right now, we got ourselves an 0-2 count for the Lady Tigers. At bat, Jado Williams. We got ourselves a 1-2 count right now. Bottom seven, one ball, two strikes, two outs. Right now is a pivotal moment right now. The game is on Jada's back right now. She got to put the team on her back.
Come on.
Daniel will follow the pitcher up if she strikes the scroll out.
All right, we got ourselves foul ball. Play it safe, play it smart.
Daniel will follow the pitcher off if she strikes the scroll out.
Okay, she's battling. I give it to her. My heart goes out to Jada right now because she is battling. She got the game in her hands right now.
She is not trying to drown.
Right. And, you know, looking at it, you know, with her having a batting average of 113, being at bat 51 times with two hits, seven runs, and one double, I mean, if you're a pitcher, you're trying to take advantage of it right now.
Exactly.
Okay, we seeing a little bit. She's getting there.
She's tuning up the bands.
Right. Getting her feet wet. Ain't nothing but a little bit of sway, man. All right, we got ourselves a 2-2 count. Dang, we're at another situation right now. Two balls, two strikes, two outs.
It's all on her.
This is game right here. Jesus. Ourselves a 3-2 count right now. You get the game plan. She's most likely gonna take that walk, get that runners at van.
Oh yeah.
Then we got Tamaya at bat coming up next. It's all on Jada right now. No pressure. Yeah. Well, maybe a little bit.
A little bit.
A lot right now. Okay, she will take the walk. Tamaya Johnson is at bat. So the game plan right now is let Tamaya get another chance in life and hit to that left field. We got two designated runners substituting for the Grambling State Tigers. Number 10, Taylor Graham, and number 21, Crystalyn Higgins.
Yeah.
Taylor Grams at first base and Crystalyn Higgins at second as your designated runners. I like the game plan that Coach Hall is doing right now. You're getting these two designated runners right here. You're putting in these two designated runners who are two or three for strikeout attempts, to stolen base attempts, and you got Taylor Grams going 2 for 2 for stolen bases. So I like the strategy. You got two girls right now who is experts in stealing bases. And you got a veteran hitter like Tamaya Johnson who can hit the ball when it's in clutch situations. Now it's just, you know, for Maya to just put it in right now. You get what I'm saying? All right, we got ourselves a 2-2 count. Dang. Just in the fort.
We're trying to stay alive.
Yeah. Two strikes, two outs. Let's keep this game alive right now for Tamaya Johnson. We got ourselves a timeout. We got time.
Let's see what she do.
All right, we got ourselves a 3-2 count, ladies and gentlemen. And if you're watching from the YouTube channel, we thank you wholeheartedly from the bottom of our heart here at Grambling State. As well, you can catch Dame on the Kickback at KGRM 91.5 on Mondays, and Nick Deshaun, myself, Tiger Huddle Radio, every Friday at 11 on KGRM.
100%. Tune in, please.
Nice hit. That will be ball game. Your Lady Tigers of Texas Southern improved to 15 wins, 13 losses, while your Lady Tigers of Grambling State, 13 losses and added another loss, making it 24. We thank everybody listening and tuning in. I'm Nick Deshaun.
I'm Damon Sewell.
And we're out.